So Kirk and the Enterprise have been redirected to Planet Q by Dr. Layton regarding a possible new synthetic food concentrate. Planet Q? Really? Is that located in the Alphabet Nebula, juxtaposed to the sector of the unimaginative? So what's really going on is Dr. Layton has brought Kirk here to see the leader of a theater troupe, a man by the name of Anton Caridian, who he believes is actually a man named Kodos, former governor of Tarsus IV. See? Was that so hard to come up with a clever name for a planet? Who is responsible for the mass murder of thousands of colonists on the planet 22 years ago, earning him the title of Kodos the Executioner. And only Dr. Layton, Kirk, and Lieutenant Riley know what this man truly looks like. Kirk returns to the Enterprise to do some research to see if Layton's claims are valid and decides to attend a cocktail party on the planet in order to meet the man himself. Instead, Kirk utilizes another skill he has honed over years of command in Starfleet, running mad game on Caridian's daughter, Sluts McGee. What the hell is she wearing? So as Kirk is looking for a cozy spot to seal the deal, they come across a dead body. Layton's dead body. Now Kirk knows something is up, and without really explaining why to anyone, he takes the acting troupe aboard the Enterprise and diverts his ship from its scheduled destination to drop the group off at their next stop. This allows for two things: a face-to-face confrontation between Rand and Sluts McGee, and another chance to witness the mad game running of the legendary James Tiberius Kirk.
This is the observation deck. That's the flight deck down there with the shuttlecraft.
Interesting.
Isn't it?
Tell me, Captain Kirk.
Anything?
Did you order the soft lights especially for the occasion?
If I had ordered soft lights, I'd also have arranged for music and flowers. Unfortunately, it isn't so. On the Enterprise, we try to duplicate Earth conditions of night and day as closely as possible.
Star light, star bright. I wish I may, I wish I might. Do you remember that, Captain?
It's very old.
Almost as old as the stars themselves. And the ship. All this power surging and throbbing, yet under control. Are you like that, Captain? All this power at your command. The decisions that you have to make
come from a very human source.
Are you, Captain?
Count on it.
Tell me about the women in your world, Captain.
I'd rather talk about you. You must have wanted to perform since the first time you saw your father act. When was that?
In the beginning.
Tell me about it.
That's not fair. You haven't answered my question about the women.
What would you like to know?
Has the machine changed them? Made them just people instead of women?
Worlds may change, galaxies disintegrate, but a woman always remains a woman.
All this, and power too. Caesar of the stars, and Cleopatra to worship him.
Kirk sets up poor Lieutenant Riley as bait, and guess what? He's poisoned and almost killed. Then Kirk confronts Caridian about whether or not he is Kodos, and Caridian is very evasive. But you get the sense that this is the same guy, just older, and it seems trying to get away from his own past. Meanwhile, Riley, who is recovering in sickbay, finds out what's going on and goes to seek revenge on Caridian for the death of his family. Turns out, she's the one killing off the last of the eyewitnesses who can identify her father as Kodos. She snatches the weapon of a red shirt and has now gone full-on psycho. Caridian, wanting no more bloodshed, blocks the shot meant for Kirk, which kills him. In the end, Sluts McGee has gone completely crazy. Still believes her father to be alive. It's always the crazy ones, right, Jim? Real quick, I think it's interesting that some people are very critical of the series Deep Space Nine, because they felt it was darker than what Roddenberry had in mind for Star Trek. When this episode deals with the repercussions of genocide, I think there's plenty of evidence to show that even the original series was a little dark at times. Also, we're seeing foreshadowings of Kirk's man-whoring phase is about to enter, since the character of Yeoman Rand, who was meant to be something of a love interest for the captain, will not make it past the first season. All right, next time we'll be watching The Balance of Terror. Ooh, Romulans. So, we'll see you then on The Challenge.